of an early December morning along the inter-German border is disturbed by the growl of tank diesels. A German panzer battalion churns the fresh snow in a sleepy pine forest. From the woods appears a platoon of one of NATO's most modern battle tanks, the vaunted Leopard 2. With the harvest gathered and the fields bare, the modern German army, the Bundeswehr, exercises its armored shield. Tanks were the spearhead of the German Blitzkrieg in World War II. The legendary Tiger and Panther were among the most powerful tanks to roam the European battlefields during the final years of the war. Today, they stand as silent reminders of the great armored clashes such as Kursk, Normandy, and the Battle of the Bulge. Their place has been taken in the modern Bundeswehr by tanks of the Leopard family, the Leopard 1 and the Leopard 2. The Leopard 1 was the first German tank built after the Second World War. It entered service with the Bundeswehr in 1965. Compared to its wartime antecedents, even the monstrous Royal Tiger, it's much better armed. The Leopard 1's main weapon is the standard NATO rifled 105mm gun. It is capable of hitting enemy tanks at ranges of over a mile and a half. The Leopard 1 is considerably more mobile than the tanks of World War II, with road speeds up to 35 miles per hour. This highly regarded design is the most widely distributed tank type in NATO service, with over 4,000 produced. The Leopard 1 also forms the basis for the Gepard, an anti-aircraft vehicle armed with a radar-directed twin 35mm cannon system. In the 1970s, the German Army began development of a new generation tank called the Leopard 2. Though sharing a common name with its predecessor, the Leopard 2 is in fact a whole new design. Like the M1 Abrams and British Challenger, the Leopard 2 is protected by a thick hide of advanced armor. Its frontal area is nearly impervious to the deadly threat of anti-tank guided missiles. A 120mm smoothbore gun forms the sharp teeth of the Leopard 2. This gun spits out a 20-pound metal dart projectile at speeds of over a mile per second. This same gun was later adopted on the American M1A1 Abrams tank. Precision is ensured by a laser rangefinder. To keep the gun pointed accurately during high-speed travel, it's stabilized by a high-performance system. The effectiveness of this sophisticated network of gun and sensors has been demonstrated time and time again by success at the Canadian Army Trophy Shoot. This competition pits NATO's best tank crews against a challenging array of targets. Dutch and German Leopard 2 units have often emerged on top. The Leopard 2's rough exterior appearance belies its internal complexity. The turret is manned by three crewmen. The loader is responsible for handling the tank's ammunition. The gunner aims the 120mm gun and operates the sophisticated computer-aided fire controls. The commander acquires targets and directs the rest of the crew in their duties. In spite of the technical improvements of modern tanks, the life of a tank crewman is arduous. There is ammunition to be loaded, and there are a host of other chores to keep a sophisticated machine like the Leopard 2 in good operating condition. Tanks are expensive to operate in peacetime. A tank will wear out a set of tracks every 2,000 miles, and they cost over $50,000 for a new set. Electronic simulators can help reduce the cost of training of tank crews by as much as 60%. The Leopard series uses a simulator to train new drivers. Driving a 65-ton tank at 40 miles per hour requires special skills. The simulator is linked to a scale terrain model, and the computer provides the trainee with a realistic image of the countryside. Future systems will use computer-generated images. Once the driver completes basic training on the simulator, he transfers to special training tanks for hands-on experience. Special training tanks reduce the wear and tear on actual combat tanks and are less expensive to operate. The new generation of main battle tanks is the fastest on record. High combat speeds make the vehicles difficult to hit during fighting. The Leopard 2's 1,500 horsepower diesel engine gives the tank very high cross-country speeds, up to 45 miles per hour. Its torsion bar suspension dampens the jostling of rough terrain. Modern tanks are too heavy to be made amphibious, so rivers are a major obstruction to tank movement. To circumvent this problem, the Leopard tanks are designed to snorkel underwater. The crew seals the vehicle and then employs a special tube device to provide air to the engine and crew.